Your Pixie Bedtime Story. Three Monsters at School. A story by Rudiger Paulsen. Three little monsters live under Benny's bed. Grouchy, Snatchy, and Bolly. Every day, they do monster things with Benny. They blare monster songs, make a mess, and splash monster goo. In the evening, when Benny gets tired, he calls out, "Shoo, shoo," and the monsters disappear into their hiding place. They always obey. Well, almost always. "Tomorrow is my first day of school," Benny says one evening. "School? What's that supposed to be?" grumbles Grouchy. "It's where I learn lots of stuff and get really smart," Benny replies. "We'll come with you," the monsters shout. But Benny won't allow it. "Shoo, shoo," he says. "Now it's time to sleep." The first day of school is exciting. Benny meets a lot of new children and his teacher, Mrs. Clover. But then, when they are supposed to be drawing a picture of their favorite cuddly toy, there is a banging at the door. "Come in," calls Mrs. Clover. The door opens and Benny is startled. Grouchy, Snatchy, and Bolly are standing in the doorway. "We're Benny's cuddle monsters," roars Bolly. "We want to become clever too." "Well, well," says Mrs. Clover. "Come on in. You can have a seat on the windowsill." The three little monsters rush into the classroom and jump onto the windowsill. They grimace and make a lot of noise as they do so. "Quiet, please," says Mrs. Clover. "We are drawing a picture." She hands the monsters paper and crayons. Grouchy bites into a crayon and screws up his face. "Doesn't taste good," he grumbles. All the children laugh. Only Benny rolls his eyes. Snatchy quickly scribbles all over his paper. "Done," he shouts, crumpling it into a ball and throwing it right onto Benny's table. Immediately, the other two follow suit. "Wait a minute," says Mrs. Clover, looking stern. "That's not the way to do it. Pick it up and put it in the wastebasket." "Coloring is easy. We already know how to do it," Snatchy says, grabbing his paper ball and hopping into the wastebasket. "Come here," he calls out to his friends. It's much cozier in here than on the old windowsill. But the wastebasket can't hold three wild monsters and topples over. Benny turns as red as a beet. Mrs. Clover takes a deep breath. "All right," she finally says. "What do you want to learn?"
"Really nasty monster swear words," says Snatchy.
"Yeah," the other two shout. Mrs. Clover gives it some thought. "Agreed," she says, winking at Benny. "I'll tell you the meanest monster swear word I know."
"Yes, yes, yes," the monsters cheer, jumping around excitedly. Mrs. Clover leans down and whispers, "Cucumber head."
"Cucumber head, cucumber head," the monsters roar. "That's monster mean." They splash lots of monster slime for joy. The school bell is ringing. The school day is over.
"Will you come back tomorrow?" all the children ask.
"Nah," says Grouchy, "we're already smart now." Benny grins, and so does Mrs. Clover.
"Well then," says Benny, "shoo shoo into my backpack."
Mom and Dad are waiting for Benny when he gets home.
"How was school?" they ask.
"Monster good," Benny answers, "and Mrs. Clover is really nice." In his backpack, the monsters giggle. But no one hears them.